to campaign on their behalf that the zoo must sustain or should be sustained. They have failed. As they have failed in the past, so have they failed today, because nothing, and I repeat, absolutely nothing is going to stop us. If you have joined us this evening, then you are blessed, because you are one of the very few people who will go away from here with a semblance of common sense this very evening, because here, we take no prisoners, we give you the truth the way it is. I have no time for political correctness. Here, the gospel we preach is the gospel of heaven. And here on this very earth, we know that the will of God is happening upon the lives of those that are his children. My name is Nnamdi Kanu. I am the leader of the indigenous people of Biafra, the largest mass movement on the face of the earth, bar none, exceptionally formidable group of people right across the face of this very planet earth. And by the very special grace of the Most High, we adore and we worship Tukotika Diama Purumihanine, a servant of the wonderful people of Biafra. I welcome you by saying good morning, good afternoon, good evening, and good night to some of you, because unlike any other, this is arguably the finest university on the face of this very earth. The finest university on the face of this very earth. Thank you for that. Our app was repeating, and I believe that it is fine now. I believe that it is okay now. I believe that it's okay. There was a slight technical glitch. We are doing all we can to ensure that this program this evening will be uninterrupted. Before I came on air, Facebook was doing their damn best to stop us from broadcasting on their platform. They blocked every account that I can use to go live on my own page. They were asking me to tell them where I am, that I should switch on the location of my device so that Facebook can know where I am. I don't know what they intend to do with it. And I have given them all the information they requested. They still said no, that I cannot broadcast this very evening. But fortunately for us and unfortunately for them, we are able to do so, and we shall continue to do so regardless of every attempt they make in order to try to stop the dissemination of this gospel of heaven. I welcome each and every one of you. Bring your pen and your paper with you. If you don't have it, you will not learn anything. Here this evening, we shall expose the truth that they have hidden. Here this very evening, we shall continue the ceaseless propagation of the gospel of truth, the same way that heaven has mandated us to preach it. But we must pray. And I am going to pray in the language of heaven, as I am accustomed to doing, even before the advent of English language or any other language for that matter. We do know that those of them that subscribe to the followership of Yahushua used to pray in Latin for very many years, and nobody complained. And I'm glad today that people are no longer complaining. They no longer complain because they shouldn't complain. We are preaching, we are going to pray in the oldest language known to man, in the language that God himself is being worshipped with in heaven at this precise moment. Onye dị nsọma ruo mgbe ebighị ebi. Onye ọ bụ naanị ya bụ eze ndị nsọ, onye kere ihe niile kere eke, mana o nweghị onye kere ya. Onye ọ bụ naanị ya na-agbaghara mmehie, onye ike niile nọ n'ọgbadara aka ya. Onye ịma mma ya na-ebere ya na-adịghị mma ruo mgbe ebighị ebi. Onye ọ bụ naanị ya na-azọpụta ndị ya, onye na-abọrọ ndị ya ọbọ, Chineke nna nke na-eboro ndị ya n'ihu na-azụ aka nri n'aka ekpe. Anyị wee na-arịọ gị n'uhuruchi ya nna nke ebere, n'abalị ya ụtụtụ ehihie. Ụmụ gị gbasara ka ọkpaka n'ụwa niile, eze ndị nsọ, biko n'oge ruru mgbe nnụnụ ọbụla ji alọghachi n'akpanụ, wee na-arịọ gị ka anyị si arịọ gị ụbọchị niile n'ime ndụ anyị. Onye nwe anyị na Chineke nna nke igwe, biko ka igwe gbaghara anyị mmehie, ka igwe kpọlata ụmụ gị nna nke igwe, ka anyị wee bụ abụ ọma, wee nye aha nsọ, wee bulie gị elu n'ime arụ Chukwu nna nke Brede Ngozi, biko si wee dịbuo na gboo. Mgbe ị hụrụ ndị nna anyị n'anya eze Ebube dị Ngozi, iwe gọzi ha n'ụzọ pụrụ iche, iwe ekwu okwu n'isi ha, ma nye ndị mmụọ ozi iwu n'ebe ha nọ, si na janja wiile agaghị abata n'ala nsọ gị, na Biafra bụ ala nke gọziri agọzi. Agbanyeghị nzuzu anyị na iberibe anyị niile, agbanyeghị na mmehie anyị niile, nke anyị na-eme nna nke bere dị ngọzi, anyị wee na-arịọ gị mgbaghara mmehie, ka ịhụnanya gị wee mụbaa n'ebe anyị nọ.
Ọ bụ site na amara gị na ebere gị n'ime eluigwe. Anyị wee na-ajaghị mma wee na-etoli wee na-agọzi aha nsọ gị. Na-asị nsọ 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 dịrị gị Chineke nna ka esizi ihe niile elu. Ka otuto niile na nsọpụrụ niile nrube isi niile ikpe isi ala niile dịwa edere aha nsọ gị site n'ebighị ebi ma ruo n'ebighị ebi. Ise. Ekpere ndị mmụọ ozi ka anyị na-ekpe. Chineke nna gbara m ebere. We are live and we are direct and the whole world is listening and bearing us witness. This very evening, before I go to the substance, as usual, I want us to lay down some markers. And I'm going to go to a speech that somebody kindly, should I say, edited out and circulated, a video of Obama speaking in the language of Go On. The reason why I have decided to play this very clip this evening is to remind all of our people that our enemies are numerous. I keep saying this, I have been saying it from day one, but our people, some of them don't understand. Our enemies are plentiful. There are many of them. And some of them, you cannot believe why they rose up and decided to be against Biafra. Nobody knows. That is to tell you what Biafra portends. That is to tell you how mightily blessed we are. That is why anybody who rises up opens their gob, their mouth, to castigate or cast aspersions on what we are doing, that person is a product of Lucifer. And I challenge the idiot anytime, any day, anywhere. It doesn't matter if you're carrying the Bible up and down, the New Testament, and preaching rubbish, your tithe and your offering and your collection. Once you rise up and you speak against this very noble family of IPOB, you're a product of Lucifer. I'm going to play what Obama said, that all of you may listen, and listen very, very carefully and understand. After listening to it, then I will ask you, where else have you heard this type of thing before? Then you will understand the mess that people are in. You will understand that those neo-colonialists, those people, some of them are heads of state. They want the zoo to continue to exist. They want Nigeria to continue to exist because of what they are getting from it. But because some of you are black, you are dumb, you are foolish, you are hopeless, you cannot see anything. You do not know anything. But here we open your eyes that you may see very clearly. That you may hear very well. Because everything we preach is the truth. It doesn't matter how long it takes. Some of you may remember when I used to tell you that those of us who are agitating for Biafra, we don't know how many enemies we have. Since yesterday, I have not been able to post on my own page. Facebook was asking me where I am. As you switch on the location on my device, they want to know where I am before I can post on my own page. They nearly stopped me from coming live this very evening on my page. People don't know the amount of battle we are fighting. And for you to appreciate the mess that everybody's in, I want you to listen to the former Satanist. The Satanist, Obama is a Satanist, a child of Lucifer.
I can confidently tell you that if there is anything like devilish conception, I can tell that Obama is the child of Satan, child of Lucifer. The man is evil beyond compare. The first black president of America and the very worst of them all, the worst of them all, an evil, a bloodthirsty evil man he is. I'm sure these people are listening this evening so they can convey this message to him, because the man is a failure and an evil person for that matter, and I'm going to prove it to you that Obama is evil. I told you before that Obama wanted the dead Buhari to win. It was an Islamist agenda. And from what I'm going to play for you, from what comes out of Obama's mouth, or what is about to come out of his mouth, that I'm sure that some of you have listened to it because somebody sent it to me, you will understand the mess that a lot of people are in. You will understand the reason why I speak about black people the way I do. You will understand the reason why I know that the zoo is doomed. That is the largest collection of idiots in the entire history of this planet. All of you Nigerians that have no shame and have no brain. Now listen to this very, very carefully, please. Listen to this very, very carefully. I beg of you, listen very carefully. Now listen to this.
Nigeria won the task that must be done.
What did he say?
Today I urge all Nigerians.
Now listen again.
Keep Nigeria won the task that must be done.
What did Obama say? I want people to listen again to what Obama had to say.
To keep Nigeria one, the task that must be done.
To keep Nigeria one is a task that must be done. I want those of you with internet-enabled devices to go and click or type in this very phrase. To keep Nigeria one is a task that must be done. It was the same thing that the dead Buhari echoed during his campaign. And I'm asking, you'll be asking yourself, what is the business of the US president with trying to keep Nigeria one? Is that their business? In what way does it concern them? In other words, what this man is trying to say, that the president of the United States of America, before Trump came in, the ex-president Obama, knew very well about our agitation for Biafra. He knew what we were doing even in 2015 when he was making this ad or this campaign for Buhari. Ask yourself this question. Why would a former United States president, then he was the US president, why would he come out and say that to keep Nigeria one, blowing the phrase of a mass murderer? Somebody who is in the Guinness Book of Records as one of the worst people to ever exist. Gowon is there. He's number three on the list. Number one is Hitler. I think number two is Pol Pot, or is it Stalin? And number three is Gowon. Gowon is in the Guinness Book of Records. Forget. That is why I have this special venom for any deceiving Bible-carrying idiot that uses the name and the word of God to deceive the gullible. That idiot, Gowon, is claiming that he is a born-again Christian, he's leading prayer. But in the Guinness Book of Records, he is there acknowledged as one of the worst people to ever live on the face of the earth. And Obama, being the worst president America ever had, somebody who is from, who claims his ancestry is from Kenya, but because of the money they are getting, because of the bribe, because of the corruption they are encouraging in the zoological republic that was created by Britain, this fool opened his mouth and said, to keep Nigeria one is a task that must be done. The same words used by Gowon during the war of genocide against Biafra. I want our people to reason, because I know that many black people do not reason. Most of our people do not reason. They don't sit down to analyze and to delve into issues properly. Ask yourself, what is an American president? Why should an American president be concerned about Biafra agitation? That is to tell you that Biafra is a divine project. And Lucifer and all his followers do not want Biafra to come. What I'm trying to say to you is this: anybody, regardless of who they are, any human being, anybody who rises up to castigate the agitation for Biafra, that person is a servant of the devil. Is a servant of the devil. Regardless of declaring the Bible or not, this job of keeping Nigeria one, that is a task that must be done. Go and Google it. Buhari made, when he was alive, made reference to go on, that they fought a war to keep Nigeria one. Go and look at it. Ask yourself this question: why would Obama use exactly the same words of go on, a mass murderer and a killer? That tells you the extent of opposition that Biafra is getting, even from quarters and from people you least expect. That is why this is God's project. It doesn't belong to man. God's project. Can you imagine that throughout Obama, 8 years of Obama's presidency, he was working for one Nigeria, not to make Nigeria a better place, but that he said the task, which means Obama quite literally placed the United States Army at the disposal of Buhari when he was alive. That the task of keeping Nigeria, that to keep Nigeria one is a task that must be done. The same words that Gowon used, I said the same verbatim, the same words that Gowon used during the genocide, which means that Obama is in support of 5 million Biafrans that was slaughtered during that very genocide. Do you see why I feel sorry for anybody who is against what we are doing? Do you see why I feel sorry for them? They don't understand what we are in. Ask yourself, what wrong did we do to Zuckerberg, the idiot that owns Facebook? Nothing. We've done nothing to him. Nothing whatsoever. I don't know if a Biafran took his wife from him or something. I have no idea. This man have consistently instructed his people to delete, to suppress. People previously, when they write or they comment and they get loads and tons of reactions. These days they write and they don't get up to 4 reactions. Up to the point that this very morning they were saying to me that I cannot broadcast live, that I must tell them where I am. Facebook, what has Facebook got to do with where I'm staying? What business of theirs is it? An American president was in the White House using the same words of a mass murderer, saying that Nigeria must be kept one. And I'm asking myself, what is the business of Obama's administration? Why would they want Nigeria to remain one? Because even Obama knows that Nigeria is there to serve an Islamic purpose. That Nigeria is there. They want to Islamize each and everybody. They want to make it the home of the most popular, should I say, populous Islamic nation in Africa. Unless you have common sense and a functioning brain, you will not understand what I'm saying. But I'm going to play it, the whole clip that you may know. And I want to publish it on my page for the world to see and to hear. What is the business? Ask that question, please, whoever is posting this clip. What is the business of Obama with Nigeria's unity? Why? What? What for? Because he's benefiting from it. They benefit from corruption. They benefit from it. That is what they are doing. I'm going to play it. Unfortunately, it is not as loud as I would like it to be. Let me play it once again that the world may hear.
To keep Nigeria one, the task that must be done.
Unbelievable.
To keep Nigeria one, the task that must be done.
Yes.
Today I urge all Nigerians.
I urge all Nigerians.
All religions, all ethnic.
All religions, everybody. Vote for Buhari.
Nigeria one.
Help and keep Nigeria one.
Advancing the security.
Help to keep Nigeria one. Have you asked yourself, why would Obama, what has Obama got to do with one Nigeria? He did not say vote out corruption. He did not say vote out ineptitude, incompetence. He did not say vote out insecurity. He said you must go to vote. You must go to vote for one Nigeria. You must keep Nigeria one. Obama is asking you to keep Nigeria one. I want people with gumption, with common sense, to understand what that means. That tells you, that was why people are asking me, oh, why do you say that Biafra is the last miracle? Because I said to them, the reason why I keep using that very term is because people are into Biafra agitation, but they don't know what they're doing. They don't know the spiritual dimension of this very effort. They have no idea. They have no clue. Satan, it was Lucifer himself, Satan Ekwensu, it was Satan himself that inspired the British, that informed the decision of Lugard to create one Nigeria in the first place. It was a satanic act. The reason being that once you suppress Biafrans in Nigeria, the whole of Africa will remain in darkness. Black people all over the world will remain subservient. They will be slaves forever and ever. That is why anybody, any human being, any idiot who rises up to say that Biafra agitation is misguided, is misplaced, shouldn't be, that person, I can swear, is working for Satan, for Lucifer. They're the same camp with Obama. I hope you can now understand it. You can now understand the level of opposition. Fulani Janjaweed is not our opposition. God in heaven knows they are nothing. They don't exist. Fulani is nothing. They are stupid. They are not educated. They are Janjaweed. What do they know? They know nothing. You people are fighting forces and principalities you don't know that hates you. If you look at Obama now, but has Obama said anything about Biafra? He doesn't know about Biafra. But Obama knows about Biafra more than all of you put together. That was why he used the word one Nigeria, to keep Nigeria one. That was the impact we are making in 2015. Think of the impact we have made up until now. Think of it. Think of it very carefully. Now you understand, don't you? Next time you must pay attention. Some of you, I don't know who brought out this very clip. Some of you see all these clips. And I keep asking myself, but most of you are learned, you're educated. Can't you reason? Can't you, when somebody is saying something, can't you go behind the lines and try to make out what that person actually is talking about or what they mean? Why would a sitting U.S. president use the same words as Gowon used during the Biafran War? What does that tell you about our agitation all the way back in 2015? Why did I say this? Because earlier this evening, the news broke, or should I say, information filtered out of Asorok. And according to them, they said it was Roots TV that covered it very well. And I'm using theirs, and I want it also posted, please, on my page. Roots TV. Buhari identifies Radio Biafra as a major threat to national security. Approves 654 million to stop its transmission. I hope you're listening. I want you to now tie this thing back to Obama's statement. I want you to tie everything together. I want people to understand the forces that is against Biafra. And if you ask them, why are you against Biafra? The one thing they will tell you, if you go to any learned European, any learned white person, they will tell you, we know about Biafra more than Biafrans themselves. We know what Biafra portends. We know that this should Biafra be allowed to exist. Black people, their eyes will open. Black people will no longer be the laughing stock of the whole world. Black people will no longer live in penury and in poverty, because Biafra itself is the light. Anybody who is against light is of darkness. We all know that. And once you are of darkness, you are of Lucifer. Ekwensu, Kinefe. Forget some of these idiots that you see them all over the place carrying their Bible and talking rubbish every blessed day. They are Satanists. These people are Luciferians. They worship the devil, not the living God. They worship the devil. Anybody who is against Biafra is a child of darkness. A child of darkness. Tell them, even the idiot that says he's in Uyo talking rubbish, tell the idiot Nnamdi Kanu said he's a child of Lucifer. That is why he's a failure, a complete and utter failure. From the people everywhere, those that came after him, and they are waxing strong all over the whole world. A failed, disgraceful generation. A debate I used to have with my father. When my father was alive, I said, why did you people stop fighting this very war? Why? Everybody fought. Look at Southern Sudan. They fought for 30 years. We only fought for 3 years. And we abandoned the entire thing. We gave up. Southern Sudan fought for 30 years and today they are free. And might I also add, they have the fastest growing economy in the whole of Africa. For those who will come back to start talking rubbish, people who are badly educated, people who are ill-tutored, people who don't know anything, people who are so empty and so vacuous, all they do is to gravitate towards where the money is. They said that they are going to stop IPU, they are going to stop Radio Biafra. Buhari identifies Radio Biafra as a major threat. The same thing that he told Obama, and Obama said in 2015, that is what Aisha's boyfriend is doing today. That is what they're doing. They fall on a janjawu. They think they're smart. They think they're intelligent. People say that they are nothing. They are miscreants. They are nothing. Yet we are the number one. They said it here. Buhari identifies Radio Biafra as a major threat to national security. Approved $654 million to stop its hospital. No wonder. Hoteliers and the pipeline security guard. People who are these are property developers. Freedom fighter by day, but a hotelier by night. Inconsequential idiot. Because I kept wondering, what is this pig, Asia, who can no longer walk, who can no longer breathe properly? What is this pig doing, talking about Nnamdi Kanu and IPOB? I kept wondering. I never knew that they told them there is money coming to stop Radio Biafra. $654 million. Who wouldn't talk? Every drug is not talking. Every fool is talking against IPOB. You won't talk against Biafra because they have budgeted $654 million for you to do their dirty work. These are filthy pigs. People who are an idiot that the death, the filth that he's living under has or complete properly. Big. They were talking rubbish. IPOB, because of our 1st of October sit at home, because all over the world they saw IPOB marching alongside the Dudu agitators all over the world, something that has never happened before. Democratic Republic, we made it possible. And their masters called them, Mustafa called the idiots. Why don't you have a meeting and say something? And people have taught them a lesson. If at all they read the comments, following their useless, idiotic utterances. But they have no shame. You know somebody, it's just like a harlot who has no shame, that can fight a customer on the street. You know they have no shame. No matter what you tell them, they never go back to go and reason. They never think. Because of this idiot, the zoo allocated $654 million to stop Radio Biafra transmission. Who else commands such influence anywhere in this zoological republic? It's only us, only this IPOB, only this Radio Biafra. It doesn't matter who you are, it doesn't matter the garbage that comes out of your mouth. We are unstoppable. Unstoppable. Go and tell the idiots, you are insulting IPOB. What is 654 million naira? It's rubbish. It's chicken feed. That is nonsense. Bring out proper money. Go and feed all these idiots, all these fake freedom fighters that goes behind our back to go and collect contracts to guard pipeline, to go behind our back to go and collect money for settlement, to be building hotels all over the land, hostels. Those are the idiots that you deserve. We are IPOB. Unstoppable. Unstoppable, I tell you. Buhari identifies. Why didn't they identify you? If you are important, why were you not identified? If people say that, oh, forget them. Oh, they are mad. They don't know what they're doing. Why is your useless, idiotic, mask-wearing government spending such amount of money trying to stop what they know they cannot stop? We broadcast via satellite. You cannot shoot it down. You don't have the rockets to do it. My voice is being heard all over the place. They said this budget is for Southeast. But people in Lagos are listening to me via FM. People in Kano, they're listening to me via FM this very night. People in Abuja, they're not listening to me via FM. So how much are you going to budget for Arewa? How much are you going to budget for Middle Belt? And how much are you going to budget for the West? Because we are rolling out more. This Radio Biafra is going to be in every community preaching the truth. All that nonsense from Obama, Keep Nigeria One, has gone. We have destroyed it completely. People now have their eyes open. They can reason. The level of consciousness currently obtainable in the Zoological Republic is as a direct result of the grace of God upon Radio Biafra and IPOB. No other thing. For your information, they are bringing out money to stop us. That's what they do. Is it today we started seeing this rubbish? Every time they bring out money. Even remember in 2015, now we are formidable. Now we are sound. Now we are sound. That I can assure you. Facebook can do all they can. They can block, they can do all they can. But let me assure Facebook. Facebook, do you know that somebody went to a zoo embassy? I'm not going to say the place in the Middle East. Are you aware? The consular staff inside there was grumbling and saying that this man's picture that is here is no longer living. Are you aware of that? Facebook, are you aware of that? You're saying if you people think you can protect, what is unprotectable. You think you can collect money and be fooling everybody. Obama thinks he can collect money. Obama was a complete and utter failure. Of course, I'm not surprised. He's a black African man as useless as every other useless, idiotic head of state from Africa is. You support evil. You support evil. We are saying to Facebook, look at the ear, look at the ear, look at the ear. He is wearing a face mask and his ear is bent like Mama. Why is his ear bending? How come Jonathan's ear did not bend? And Facebook is saying it is hate speech. You are banned for 3 days. You are banned for 1 week. We will remove your post. Facebook, but you have not answered the question. Why is the ear of the man bent? They can't answer it. Because they are fighting Biafra. They think they can defeat us. They think they don't know who. These idiots have no idea who we are. They have no idea how stubborn we are. They have no clue how determined we are. They have no idea the extent we are prepared to go, what we are prepared to sacrifice to ensure that Biafra is restored. Now that madness is no longer restricted to only IPOB. Our people in Oduduwa have the same mindset, and very soon Middle Belt will join as well. So how do you think you can stop us? Who is the idiot? No wonder, because I kept wondering, maybe they don't have money anymore. You know these idiots, anytime they run out of cash to maybe buy cement, because they're always building, they always have a project that they're running. Anytime they run out of money, they look for something to say, to tell their masters in Abuja, oh God, we are still here. We are still here fighting IPOB. I kept wondering why. When I saw this news this evening, I knew that was the reason why, because somebody has to share this 654 million. Somebody has to share it. And that's why somebody gave them, maybe Loretta Noche gave them inside information. The money is coming. Oh, if you know you're castigating IPOB and Nnamdi Kanu, please intensify, because money is coming. 654 million. That is why they were mouthing rubbish. I'll read it out so that people can understand how formidable we are, how strong we are. Nobody ever mentions their name. Nobody will ever mention their name. They are insignificant. They are inconsequential. It's only IPOB that they know. I'll read you the headline again. Buhari identifies Radio Biafra as a major threat. Buhari, meaning Aisha's boyfriend, of course, wearing the mask with the common ear. You see his ear always bending all the time, because it is not a human ear. It is common sense. But idiots in the zoo, they lack common sense. All those wild animals that Lugard put together. The shame of the black race, Zoological Republic of Nigeria. Buhari identifies Radio Biafra as a major threat to national security, approved 654 million to stop its transmission. Now I'll read the news in full so you can understand it very well. Nigeria's President Muhammadu Buhari has approved 654 million naira to combat illegal radio transmission across the southeast, with his administration declaring such practices as a major threat to national security. We are the major threat, not any other person, not any other entity. It is only IPOB, the ones they are afraid of. Why are people now talking? If our Yoruba brethren were just doing their agitation on their own, no, I'm sure most of them would dismiss it. But because they are with IPOB, that is the fear. That is the respect they now command. That is a fact of life. What I'm telling you is the truth. And they understand it to be the truth. Now listen very carefully. They are coming to combat, they call it illegal radio transmission. The president shared today's Federal Executive Council, the idiot wearing Aisha's boyfriend wearing a mask with Omo Iyedeke. Nobody can address it. I have asked Facebook, can't you see the boys here? I have asked every idiot, I have asked AFP fact check. Why don't you fact check the ear? Do the fact check on the ear and tell me if that ear that is bending like Omo all the time is the ear of a human being or if that is silicone. They know it is silicone, they know it's plastic. Everybody knows that very well, but they will not do it. They want us to stop saying, oh, that Buhari is alive. Anybody claiming that Buhari is alive, you are a supporter of liars. You are a liar yourself. Look at the ear. And as we have promised them, this year or next year, anytime he decides to come out again, we have prepared people who are willing and ready to die, to give up their life in order to prove to the whole world that this idiot wearing a mask is a little boy and a boyfriend of Aisha Buhari. We are making it very clear to them. Wherever this idiot is seen abroad, we are going to approach him, we'll pull off his ear, that the world may see that the ear is fake, that they may see it. People pretend, people lie. I don't know the type of world that we are living in, that people can no longer stand up and be brave enough to speak the truth. No more. But they never counted on us, on IPOB, because here we speak the truth always. Now, let me continue doing with this very news. The president chaired today's Federal Executive Council meeting, where the decision was taken following a presentation from Communications and Digital Economy Minister Issa Pantani. The fund was released the same today. He made a presentation today, and the money was released the same day. No deliberation, nothing. That is how desperate they are. If what we are saying is not the truth, why would they be voting such huge sums of money to try to stop us, using it to bribe washed out, compromised, failed, completely failed freedom fighters? Failed. I shouldn't even be using the word freedom fighter to address these economic desperados. They would do anything. If Dangote comes tomorrow and say, I have a new pipeline now from Warri to Lagos, please, I need security guard, you idiot, will jump out. People without shame. Anytime there is land somewhere in Dowe, that people are in distress, maybe somebody is in hospital, they want to sell land. Idiots, Ochicha, looking like Oshomole, as ugly as anything you can think of, will jump out and buy. These are the idiots that they want to be regarded as human beings. These are the fools that they don't know how enlightened people are now. They don't know how enlightened, how intelligent people have become. That we can see them from 10 miles away. Oh, they're not doing anything. The county is not doing anything. But if your federal government is paying you. They are paying you money. They are paying you money to become an informant. You have been reduced to an informant. Tell us where IPOB radio is. That is what they're doing. And because they have promised them that they know where our transmitting stations are, that is why they have voted money for them. Now they're encouraged. Now you know them very well. The fund was released to procure and deploy a hybrid spectrum monitoring system that will cover the southern part of the country, most importantly the southeast. The communications minister informed the press that 106 of 320 frequencies were uncovered as illegal through an investigation that was conducted across the northeast, northwest, north central, southwest, and south south. But then why are you focusing on southeast? Because they know we are preaching the truth. Because they know that the truth will set you free. They know that now the eyes of our people have opened. Of course, there is hunger. Of course, there is hunger. Any governor can assemble a bunch of idiots anytime, any day. to do their bidding for them, because people are wretched. They are black people that are very hungry. After all, even in Biafra land, there are black people. Very desperate, very hungry, very useless and very hopeless. They are everywhere. They are the ones they can buy. They are the ones they can purchase. They are the ones they can connive with BBC to go and be deceiving themselves. They can deceive us. Not now, not tomorrow, not ever. Now listen. It is because of the agenda of the President Muhammadu Buhari on promoting security that we come up with this initiative of monitoring the usage of frequencies and uncovering the legal and illegal ones. They cannot do nothing. You cannot track an FM. You cannot. Not today, not tomorrow. The technology doesn't exist. You can do all you can. We broadcast via satellite. So what are you going to do? This idiot, you once in a while you want to make money and you say to you full any janjaweed. You know, they don't like to hear IPOB and then the kind of those two names, they don't want to hear. It drives them insane. It drives them mad. So if you want to make money, just go to them. Oh, I have a way. We can now stop IPOB. We can stop Namdekan. We know what to do. Trust us. You can now see what we are doing. Did you see my interview the other day? What I was saying? Oh, I was castigating them. That is all they can do. They know we are unstoppable. No idiot born of an bagger can stop us. They have not given birth to you. They have not given birth to you. Our land must be cleansed, sanitized, and cleaned. That mentality of defeatism, of cowardice, and of treachery that obtained in 1970 can no longer obtain. We fought a war and gave up just like that. They should have continued fighting that war, even if it means the death of everybody. Let those who are alive continue with the next generation of Biafra. Nonsense. That is why today Fulani Janjaweedism is everywhere. People are pretending and they are lying. People are carrying the Bible. Somebody carrying the Bible, the word of God. The idiot has not, he has not. About the killing in Ozuwane, never heard about our mothers being killed in Ebonyi State. That idiotic preacher of Dave Umahi opening his mouth, lamenting that Fulani people are raping our mothers in Ebonyi. Send it to that idiot. That's what he wants, so that he can be given money from Abuja. He's a fool, carrying the Bible and deceiving himself. He's a complete and all-round idiot. He is. Complete idiot he is. A very, very foolish man. That is the money they have brought out for them to go and share. And that is why every idiot is mouthing every nonsense that comes into their brain. Radio Biafra, this is according to the news. Radio Biafra, managed by IPOB leader Nnamdi Kanu, is one of the most popular stations in the Southeast. It is everywhere, not a witchy, useless Southeast. It is everywhere. The whole of Africa, people are listening. They are being educated. People are listening in the USA. Professors, people who are learning, are listening in Argentina. You're saying it's popular in the South. Which Southeast? Take up, you know, come there around, useless set of people everywhere. You think we're here to massage words or to romance words? You must be joking, you must be kidding. That is that, and we are proceeding, of course. We are proceeding. They have employed a grand hybrid spectrum. The same hybrid spectrum you employed in 2014, it didn't work. 2015, 2016. We are going from strength to strength. This very evening, this very gospel is being heard in Ghana. He's in Lagos. He's in Abuja. And you're still busy writing rubbish. The more you try to fight IPOB, the stronger we become. The stronger we become. Nobody born of an idiot in Africa can stop what we're doing. They've not given birth to you. I will be here. You've not been born. You can't. Who are you? You can't. Stupid set of people everywhere. You think you can stop what we are doing? I think you are demented. Somebody said something very, very interesting, and as a matter of fact, I want to play that clip and want it posted. I don't know if we have it. I call it the era and the age of idiocy in our land. And when I was saying this, I did blame Ohaneze I did blame one idiot was talking somewhere. Hanese President General, PJ, one monkey like that, looking like Oshomole. That is how you know idiots. No matter all this money they have stolen from the government, all this bribe they have received, all the nonsense that they have, you know, dabbled into in order to remain relevant. You look at them and their body is as shriveled and as dry as stockfish. The idiot was talking nonsense. And from this clip I'm going to play now for people to hear, they can understand that Ohanaeze is a failure, a complete and absolute failure. Idiot, you claim you went to school, you come out and you say that the Igbo people of Southeast, only 5 states. How about the Igbo people in Edo State? How about the Igbo people in Benue State? How about the Igbo people in Eko, in Cross River State? People don't reason. How about the Igbo people in Akwa Ibom? People don't reason. Sociocultural. He was like, you have forgotten Operation Python Dance, those who instigated it. They think we are foolish. You have been implicated in the coming of Operation Python Dance that led to the death of very many people, my parents included, as a consequence of it. And you just want us to allow you to go scot-free. Are you insane? Are you out of your senses? Are you out of your mind? So you don't understand it? Useless set of people everywhere. They think they are smart. The same thing that I said to Facebook. Facebook, when I used to make posts before, the minimum number will be about 8,000, 9,000, 10,000, 11,000, 12,000. Over the months, they kept suppressing it until now. This is now at 2.5. They cannot allow more than 2.5, 2,500 reactions on my post. Despite their suppression, Facebook will still go behind to remove every post that I make. Because they know, despite their suppression, in every 28 days, I reach 8 million people. Despite everything they have written, despite their suppression, 8 million people every 28 days. They suppress and they suppress and they suppress and it's not working. Now they go and remove the post that I make. That is how powerful we are. That is how formidable we are. Now I am telling all these okoko, you want me to respect people that have to come and kill us in our own land, in our own compound. But because you're foolish, because you're very senseless and idiotic, you think that people think that what we are doing, we can be bought over. Maybe they are doing it because of money. They have tried, money did not work. Oh, they are doing it because of this. They have tried, it didn't work. Oh, they want to be famous. They have tried, it didn't work. But you were given one chunk of one small Ghana must go bag, and you sold your conscience and who you are. Shameless way people behave like prostitutes. They have no shame. They have no shame. That's how you know them. If they had a shame, Ohanaeze would not exist. I tell you, I'm going to play a clip for you. I'm going to play a clip of somebody who is from Ikwere, and you hear what he's saying because people listen to us. What has been the job of Ohanaeze? You know that your land was balkanized, gerrymandered, divided. They went to Ebema, they cut Ebema into three, they came to Ohanji, they divided Ohanji into two. They went everywhere, they went to Andoni, they said they're no longer everywhere. What did you do? Because people who are in Ohanaeze are direct. These are slaves to Fulani. They receive money from Fulani. They are working for Fulani agenda. They are working for an agenda that says one Nigeria, that will make sure that we are subsumed in the wider Fulanization, Islamization project going on in the zoo, supported by Britain, supported by Obama before he left office. If you don't know, let me tell you. These are the things that some of you do not understand. Because you are blind. Even in the spiritual, you are blind. You cannot see. You cannot read between the lines. You cannot understand what somebody is saying. I don't know how to say that in English. Translate for them, please. Before, when you are a child, when you have a visitor in your house, your mother will look at you. By me looking at you, you understand the message she's trying to convey.
If you don't understand, if you grew up in the village, all these idiots that grew up in the township that know nothing about our way of life and our way of and our culture, you people are the ones they are using to mess up our way of life, and it cannot work. That's what this brother has to say. Because a lot of people don't understand what is going on. But here we educate you, we enlighten you, we inform you. Now, I'm going to play something for all of you to please try and listen to. Listen. Listen.
Want to recognize His Majesty, mm-hmm. The Obi of Onitsha.
His Acknowledging Obi of Onitsha.
Doff my hat for you, sir.
Mm-hmm.
The PG Oaneze.
Yes.
Chief Nayawodo.
Yes.
And Dr.
Elias, the Chairman of the Education.
Yes.
I want to thank every one of us that have spoken. We've spoken very well. I want to talk on a little bit on integration.
Listen, integration.
Nation.
Igbo nation. He's an Igbo man. He's talking about Igbo nation. Because I want people to understand that when we preach on this very platform, we are under divine instruction from heaven to preach that truth uncompromisingly, because that truth will set us free. They were saying, oh, if it, Igbo land is only, is five states, is a certain. I said to them, no. You must go and look for your people. You must go and look for your people. You are in a dust state. You are everywhere. We are fighting for Biafra. Yes, that is true. But this Biafra is going to be based on ethnic identity. So nobody will feel cheated. Everybody will be recognized. We have said it time and time and time again. And listen to what they say. The same Ipure they said is not Igbo. The same Ipure. Listen very carefully, please. The same Ipure. Listen. He's coming.
To be done. Listen. Within the larger Igbo speaking group.
Larger.
The minorities which I represent. My name is Andy Wabali.
Wabali.
I'm an Ikwiri. I'm from Ikwiri. I'm from Isiobo.
Isiobo.
Government.
Yes.
My people, we call ourselves the Uraha people.
Uraha.
And our relationship, I want to dwell very much on our relationship and what the way forward that will go, since this is Hanese, yesterday,
mm-hmm.
present, mm-hmm. and in the future. I see myself very much as an Igbo man.
Are you hearing it? Wabale. He sees himself as an Igbo man. He is now coming to make a case for the inclusion of Igbo people in the mainstream of what Ohanaeze is doing. Which is what I've been preaching from day one. You must go and look for your people. Even if they are so foolish as to say they are not who they are, you must look for posterity's sake. But after the war, the Fulani man said to them, outside these five states or East Central states, you cannot go. It was IPOB that came and changed the narrative and said that is all rubbish. All rubbish. You cannot have somebody answering Ifani Chukwu in a Edo state, in a Banke, speaking Igbo. Ifani Chukwu, you say he's not Igbo. You are talking absolute paper. You are talking nonsense. I will not have it. They said, you are trying to land a grab. I said, you are talking absolute garbage. The Igbo people. And I asked Ohanaeze to do this. You know, we advise them, they go behind our back and they carry out that same project we've been talking about. And they come out in the public and they can't even give us credit for it. They can't give us credit for it. So it's for all those idiots who are mouthing their rubbish about, I am from Igbo, I'm from Benin. Now Benin have said they are from Igbo. Now they are running helter skelter. We are all Igbos after all. And that is the truth of the matter. You can blend it, you can twist it all your life.
Is it going forward to address
Listen.
A lot of issues
mm-hmm.
around it? We have to be very strategic. We're entering into a nation that everybody is planning. If we go planless, it will be a very big problem for us in the future.
Mm-hmm.
We cannot remove our neighborliness. We cannot remove our evilness in us.
And the very man is telling you, you cannot remove my evilness. You can't remove it. You can't. His name is Andy Wabale. You cannot remove it. That is who they are. But if somebody, because they are serving their masters in the north, their master will tell them, you know, you see River State, is Niger Delta, don't enter there, and they will not go. But we preach the truth. We tell you who you are. It is for you to decide where you belong.
He's saying it. You cannot remove. How can you go to an Igbo man and remove the Igbo-ness in them? Is that possible? You can't do that. That is who they are. Of course, some of them, due to the criminality of abandoned property, some of them are ashamed to come out and say who they are. But we say them that property is nothing because blood is thicker than water. That's all we say to them. That's all I say to them. So they can understand it. Now you can see your hands, isn't it? You can see the work we are doing. Because every time they are ranting on radio, they are talking. Yes, they are ranting and they are talking. And let me also remind you once again of this very headline. It's a very beautiful headline. Very, very beautiful. So you understand that at least they rant and it produces something. You rant and nothing comes your way. Maybe you're looking for Loretta Onoche to hand you down some crumbs from this 654 million. I know some of you, even some of you who are so poor and so wretched abroad, you are waiting for some of these crumbs to fall on your table from Loretta Onoche. She might be generous and extend some cash to you. Buhari identifies Radio Biafra as a major threat to national security. That is who we are. Formidable and exceptional. That is who we are. And let me tell you, all your envy, all your jealousy, all your nonsense. And is if you have class, you have class. They say class is permanent. You know, form is temporary. If you see that you have it or you don't. When it comes to this pedigree, when it comes to people who are the front line of this agitation, people know IPOB and nobody else. It's not about making it's hard work and dedication and guidance from heaven. There's nothing you can do about it. That is why we are as formidable as we are. And that is why we are not only unstoppable, that is why Biafra also is inevitable. These are the people that nobody fought for. Your own people, Igwere, Ebante, everywhere, Neomaitos, IPOB, the coming. We said, yes, we are all Biafran people, but individually we must acknowledge and recognize our ethnicity. You are talking, people are talking nonsense, and there are three Igbo-speaking local government areas, part of the North. And you want me to respect people who are responsible for such an anomaly? You want me to respect Dave Umahi? You want me to respect Ohanaeze? But they are there, and they are people we are taking and giving to Sokoto Caliphate, and you want me to be quiet? This may be going on. Mad people everywhere. You idiot. Some of these people that fought the war, and the war ended in 1970, there was a mentality of cowardice that they brought. And they want to inject that cowardice in every generation that comes. Well, have you seen war before? Do you know what war is? What war is greater than Operation Python Dance 1, 2, and 3, and 4, and the Crocodile Smile? Is it not the same war? Is it not the same AK-47? The same people dying every blessed day? At the hands of these murderers? Is it not the same thing? Oh, you have not seen war. If you have seen war, if you don't know what happened. People are so foolish. Israel has been fighting war from the day they left Egypt till today. People are so foolish. The same idiot in New York claiming he is serving the God of Israel. I want to remind that very fool. I want to remind the idiot New York. He knows who he is. He knows his name. He knows himself very well. I want to remind that fool. The same God of Israel you're calling. Israel started fighting war. From the time they left Egypt, Israel is still fighting war till this very evening. Has it stopped God from loving them? People don't understand. They read, they know nothing. Because you went to war and you fought, and you were not strong enough and you were defeated. Because you were defeated, because of that, your children and their children's children must live with this defeatist mentality. They must be defeated by Fulani. Fulani, oh, don't fight them. Oh, don't rise up. Oh, what IPOB is doing is mad. Don't. Because you were defeated and you are not him, you're not man enough to rise up and say to hell with these people. Now you want your children to become as cowardly as you are. Are you not ashamed of yourselves? Are you not ashamed of yourselves? Do you think we're going to capitulate to Fulani Janja with them? You're mad, you're insane, you don't know nothing. In Ebonyi, Miyeti Yala is packing their cattle and they're going back to the north. If you don't know. Consistency and diligence. Miyeti Yala is running away from Ebonyi State. And I told them they will run from the Ebonyi State and they are running. If they said that the cattle would die with them, and they understand it very well. Giyot, because you lost the war in 1970. Because of that, all the generations to come must be as cowardly as you are. You are a coward. Is God a coward? I'm asking you. You idiot with New Testament talking rubbish. Is God a coward? I'm asking you. The same God of Israel. The same God of Israel. The same God of Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. The same God you call upon for your tithe and your offering. The same God that made Israel very strong and preeminent. You learn nothing from history. You learn nothing from the Bible. All you know is tithe, offering, and collection. And to imbibe your stupid, idiotic, cowardly nature in your children, not ashamed of yourself. You're not ashamed of yourself. You call yourself a child of God. You're a child of Lucifer. You're a coward at that, for that matter. Senseless people, you want to infuse the same cowardice in this generation. This fearless generation, that's what you want to do. You cannot succeed. In the Arab and Ime, you cannot succeed. That is why, tell me this type of elders, I keep asking people all over, tell me which country in the world, when Yoruba wanted presidency, Yoruba did not go begging anybody. Yoruba agitated and agitated and agitated until they allowed Olufaraye and Obasanjo to contest in 1999. Common sense, something very simple, it has come to their own turn. That mentality of defeated people, we have been defeated in war. Because of that, we need to beg. 2023 presidency, that's the headline. Tinubu should not contest. Igbos ready to go down on their knees to beg. Always begging. You've been begging for over 50 years. You beg, you beg, you beg, you beg. Nothing comes your way. The little crumbs you have now, the little things, the fact that even the Fulani are looking in your direction is because of IPOB. Because of what we are doing. But somebody, people that I don't understand this type of thing. These are people that I used to respect. You come out and say you go down on your knees and beg. What type of elders are these? What type of people are these? Are you people the only ones to lose a war before? What type of thing is this? You will go down on your knees to beg who? I'm asking you. If you're men, you go down on your knees to beg. I have never heard of such nonsense. I have never heard of such nonsense before. Unbelievable. You are going to beg. You are going to beg. Who tells you that power concedes to people who that beg? You take it by force. You saw the way the Fulani is with the help of Obama. Islam is how they removed Jonathan from office. They begged Jonathan to give them power. They took it from him by force. You were there as a witness. These are learned men. That is what is driving me mad. Learned men. You want to go and beg. Beg who, I ask you. Who are you begging? Are you not ashamed of yourselves? Beg somebody for what? For presidency. Unbelievable. That is the mind. Do you see the cowardly mindset they want to put in our brain? This is how they want to condition us. So that in the next two generations, we are finished. If we carry this nonsensical mindset, oh, we lost the war. Have you seen war before? We lost the war in 1970. You have not seen war. Is America not at war today? Is Britain not fighting a war today? They conquered you with war. They are still fighting till today. Is even the Fulani not fighting? Is Mietiana not fighting till today to conquer you? You want to go down on your knees to beg. To beg who, I ask? Who in front of me here? You have previously posted something that didn't follow our community standards. You won't be able to go live. Do you know that? Am I not live on the same Facebook? Because we have a never say die attitude. We continue relentlessly. You kill us and we continue. You kill us and we keep. If you kill 10, we come. You next time you see 20. You can never kill us fast enough as our mothers are giving birth to us in Biafra land. That's how God made it.
What are you afraid of? All of you cowards, what are you afraid of? Who are you afraid of? Why are you afraid? Is somebody who is moving cattle from Denachinama, Kuruna Tuebu? And you want us to grow up or to raise our children with that mentality? We fought war. They have not seen war before. You fought a war and you failed in that very war. You are a failure. Because the same time you are fighting, John Garang was fighting in the bushes of South Sudan. Today they are free. They are free. So don't come to infuse your cowardice, your cowardly nature. Don't come to contaminate this great generation. We won't have it. Live in your fear and in your cowardice. You lost a war. We did not lose any. Your generation lost a war. You lost it, not us. We have learned from our mistakes, from the mistakes that you made. And we're not going to make the same mistake. Be rest assured. Can I assure you of that? All this nonsense, stupid, idiocy has been dreaming. Obama is telling you about keeping Nigeria one. You don't want to ask yourself, what is this wretched idiot from Kenya who got lucky in America? What business has he? He claims he's a Democrat. He believes in democracy. Democracy is the rule of the people. Not by one idiot in the White House talking rubbish. And you want it. You are afraid to speak the truth. And you call yourself a man of God. You call yourself an elder. You go down on your knees and beg. Beg who, I ask you? Did the Fulani people beg? Did they beg anybody to become the president, I'm asking you? Did the Yorubas beg anybody to become the president? You people are disgracing us. To come and take up on his state. He thought I was joking. They cannot take it. All this looking like when like Oshomole talking rubbish. Nonsense. You've done nothing. I can say that we drove away Mietiala from Ebonyi State. And they will go. I'm telling you the truth, they will go. Their cattle says that a cattle will die, and they know it very well. That they must go from Ebonyi State. It's not about hiring a few people, opening up a few shops during our sit-at-home, you invite BBC. That agent of Satan, you are just fooling yourselves. You don't know, do you know how hardened we are? Do you know how prepared we are? So you people think, you're just thinking maybe they just got up one morning and decided to do agitation for Biafra. How foolish all of you are. What we are doing, it's divine. It is no Jupiter. And for this zoo, for them attempting this rubbish, I'm going to make sure there is a radio in Katsina. There will be Radio Biafra in Katsina. Someone is talking. Aisha Buhari and the children, when they go on holidays, they'll be hearing it. There will be Radio Biafra in Katsina. for them to know how strong, how formidable. They think, you see, all these influences that go to them, oh, we are begging you, oh, please, now, we are here, we lost one, we are begging you. You're dealing with the wrong people. We are their friends. We are the children of the soil. We are all over the world. We don't depend on any of them for finance and for help. Chukwukikabiam is in control. All of that nonsense they are making you to feel good, to feel better, you are wasting your time. We are the ones you should be afraid of. And that's fully so. I am giving you only 6 weeks that will be ready to be after in Katsina. I will take this very battle to your homes individually, all of you. There will be Radio Biafra in Katsina in 6 weeks from today. If there is no radio there, then you know you discount me as a human being. 6 weeks, there will be radio in Katsina. Radio Biafra will be in Katsina. Mad people everywhere. Janjaweed, you can play and toy with the minds of our father's generation. Because they lost the war, and because of that, they imbibed a mentality of cowardice. Don't talk. You have not seen war before. Don't talk. So the people fighting war now for Israel, they were with Moses when they crossed the Red Sea. Yeah? They were with Moses when they crossed the Red Sea. Those who are fighting now, or they were the ones that fought with Moshe Dayan, that fought with Golda Meir and David Ben-Gurion in 1948. Isaac Shamir and Isaac Rabin. And so this present generation of Israeli soldiers, they were there in 1948. You see how foolish some people are. You want to infect us with your cowardice so we can all be cowards. Don't do anything. If not that we stood up against Fulani Janjaweedism in Ebonyi State, do you think that Mietiana would have called for Dangote trailer to pack their cattle and go back to the north? Do you think so? If all the time they were doing what they were doing with Dave Umahi and we kept quiet, saying, oh, leave the governor has spoken. By now, Mietiana will be everywhere in Ebonyi State, but they cannot be. The order was given. I gave the order. They can never have peace in Ebonyi State until they leave. And they are leaving. It doesn't matter how many people they give money to who are answering Abdul Aziz, who are answering Mazi Al-Hajja, Abdul Latif Udoji, of such crappy, stupid names. It doesn't matter. Their own time will come. Their own time will come. They want to destroy the work of God. God in heaven will destroy all of them. Mietiana should better pack everybody and go. Go back, bring your cattle, go to Kariki or whatever. Or Maza, where they sell Nama. Go and sell your cattle and then you go back. Or you hire a house in the town and leave. You see our forest and our bushes, you cannot stay there. We have some security in the... There must be a security outfit. We don't need one. We don't need any. We don't need any. We are everywhere. On the ground in Biafra land, we are everywhere. Where we say there will be no Mietiala, there will be no Mietiala. Ebonyi State is number one. When we finish with Ebonyi, we're going to Enugu until we drive them away from our farmlands and our forests. It's not something you put on a press statement. Let that picture teach all of them a lesson. That is how it's going to be everywhere. All of them, they are going to suffer. I said all of them, they are going to suffer. Mad people everywhere. Useless, idiotic people. They think we are joking. They think leave them. Do that nonsense with the stupid idiot that looks like Oshiomhole. He can't do that nonsense with us. He wants to go and build more hotels. You can give him money to build more hotels, not us. We don't need your money. All we want is our freedom. That is all we are asking for, is our freedom. The time now is 19 minutes past 8 p.m. in the blessed land of Biafra. 19 minutes past 8 p.m. We are live and we are analysis, views, and commentaries this very evening, morning, afternoon, or night, depending on where you are. What we speak is the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth. We don't indulge the damnable geological republic because they have nothing to offer. Anybody who believes in Nigeria is a mad animal. Is an animal. Is not worthy of existence. Even this very traditional ruler, an 80-year-old traditional ruler, Joseph Ogunfuwa, in tears, completely regrets campaigning and voting for APC in 2015. A traditional leader in Ogun State, Joseph Ogunfor, has expressed his regret for campaigning for the dead Buhari in the 2015 general elections. He said this in Ogun State. He said that this present regime is a disappointment, not just for himself, but for the generality of Zulu people that they call Nigerians. He spoke at a public lecture held in Sagamu to mark his 80th birthday. In his words, "What I regret most in my life was the do or die campaign I did for Mr. President during the 2015 general elections. I was overconfident that among the self-proclaimed leaders hustling for the presidency at the time, you, Buhari, were the only person who appeared to me to be able and capable of saving our great country. I don't know when Nigeria became great. I have no idea. They are great. They have no electricity. They have no good roads. They have no schools. They have 4 refineries, but they import fuel. So when people say that Nigeria is great, please, 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 I beg of course, great in stealing, great in looting, great in mediocrity, and great in Fulani and Janjaweedism. They talk about greatness as if there was a time that Nigeria was great. Great in what aspect? I'm asking you. You sell oil and gas from my blessed land of Biafra. That is the only thing that you have. When people say that Nigeria is great, I want to ask them how, when, where did Nigeria become great? He even said that some of my friends deserted me. Some thought I was crazy. Of course, you're crazy. Anybody, if you're campaigning for Fulani Janjaweed, you must be very crazy. I keep asking you before. If one of them was a man, boy, if your road is good, and at least you take it once. I'm asking you, what is it that the Fulanis have contributed to the national advancement of Nigeria before? Just tell me in the past. Just name one thing they have done. Are they poets? Have they written any book of note? Are they artists? Are they sculptors? Are they painters? Can you tell me one thing they have done, if not move cattle from place to place, pillage, rape, and loot? What else have they done? Nothing. But when they come out, you vote for them. That's how foolish you are. Foolishness is doing the same thing over and over again and expecting a different outcome. And I'm asking you, all of you that believe that a Fulani man can save you, I'm asking you to go back in history. Tell me one thing that they have done that has benefited the whole country. Absolutely none. Nothing whatsoever. What does that tell you? What does that tell you? That tells you all you need to know. But out of foolishness and idiocy and stupidity, and of course, what I call the Obama factor, keeping Nigeria one. So if keeping Nigeria one means anybody can wear a bun ear and be all over the place, then so be it. So be it. So be it. So all I want to know is, I want to ask, are you telling me that this person with his ear that is rubber bending all the time when he's wearing a mask, is that a human being? Nobody can answer that. Facebook cannot answer. Nobody can answer this very simple question. I want to ask again, all of you in the zoo, all of you Nigerians, all of you that claim that you went to school, you are graduates, you are learned, you educated, let me ask you once again, have you seen the ear of the idiot, the little boy you call your president? Is that a normal behavior of an ear when they are wearing a mask? If that is normal, why come Jonathan's ear itself has not gone bummer the way this boy's ear has done? Kanda, you know Kanda very well. Some of you eat Kanda. Go and look at the ear. I keep asking, why can't people ask simple questions? Why is it that people who claim they're educated, that they went to school, they cannot ask a simple question? Why is the ear of the president bending? Why is it that the president had a hole in the neck when he was in Cuba? Nobody can explain, nobody can answer that. Nobody is even asking the question to start with, apart from us. We in IPOB on this very platform, that is why they said we are a security threat to the zoological republic. And I want people, all our coordinators all over the world, to make sure that this very news coverage today forms part of the understanding of their host country, of our predicament and our situation. So let nobody come back and say that we are not imperiled in the zoological republic. We want the world to know how formidable we are and how frightened the zoo is of this very noble family, IPOB. That is something that people must understand. Now, this very man have gone and said that this is my message to politicians, presidents, governors, lawmakers, senators, Christians, Muslims, traditional rulers, and others. Everybody in the zoo is in a complete mess. Complete and utter mess. They know what to do and they have refused to do it. That is what makes them black people. I want to write about it. Facebook will start complaining. They'll start
is looking for posts to ban, who to delete. And to make matters worse, they snapped, they brought an oversized barrel, something they constructed somewhere in Agbonema. They loaded a few empty containers on it, and they moved it to Onitsha. And they said that Onitsha River Port has now opened. And because the zoo, people don't think. When they asked me what I wanted, I added this river port as one of the things that I would like to see reopened many years ago. So now they think that they can get to our people, they can get you to become a one Nigerian by this stunt. The stunt is that they moved a badge, which is a drum that somebody welded together, put empty containers on top of it, and they took a picture to deceive the idiotic and the gullible, to tell you that Onitsha River Port has now opened. That is what they do. And they are very foolish. And I want this picture published on my page, please. If you look further down, you will see the same second Niger bridge that are telling you that they have completed. This picture was taken about 2 days ago, or was it yesterday? You will see the same second Niger bridge they've been telling you since that they have completed. They are taking pictures and telling you, oh, how well that they have done. You will see that nothing is going on. You can see it. That the river is quite open. You can see the old Niger bridge. You can see the one that is under construction. The work hasn't even been completed. It hasn't even gone 40%. You can see it there. But they're building a railway line to Niger Republic. Whereas the oil that, my goodness, the oil that made Dangote a billionaire, the oil and gas that is sustaining the zoo, the only thing that they have is coming from this land. To build a common bridge is a problem, but they are building a railway line to Niger Republic. That tells you all you need to know. So for all the details talking about one Nigeria, how things can be better, can you see what I'm seeing? Can all of you see what we are seeing? Can you see the depth or the level of idiocy of some human beings? Look at the second Niger bridge, they cannot complete it, but they have money, they have found money to go and build a railway line to Niger Republic. What does that tell about their priorities? And for the idiots who found it within themselves to rise up against this noble family of IPOB, that everybody, that the forces of darkness that Lucifer is afraid of. Everybody is afraid of IPOB, and why won't you be? We are exceptional and we are highly formidable. The same oil and gas they are taking from our land, they have gold in the north. But in the north, they are mining their own gold. The state government is importing equipment to process their gold. And you have idiots in Biafra land. In Biafra land, all they can think of is, oh, IPOB is our problem. What Nnamdi Kanu is doing. But in the north, they have a natural resource. They have gold and they have diamond. Today, they have gone and imported machinery to start processing their gold. It belongs to them. But the oil and gas in our land belongs to everybody. Now, who is foolish? You or these people who are controlling you? Look at the stunt. This is how foolish they have made our people become. They took I'm not even sure that this thing, maybe it's just Photoshop, they just added something to it. Say, oh, Onitsha River Port has opened. You say, oh, hallelujah, God has done it. People are so foolish, so gullible, so dumb, so foolish. Unbelievable. Unbelievable. The North is mining their gold, but in Biafra land, everything we own belongs to the North. Our oil, our gas belongs to the North. Zamfara obtained the equipment to begin gold refining. Zamfara estate obtained, they went and bought equipment to start refining their gold. That is why Obama said, one Nigeria, that to keep Nigeria one is a task that must be done. You can see it. Keeping Nigeria one means Biafra land, oil and gas. There is oil and gas, there is oil in Ebonyi. There is coal and oil in Enugu. Anambra has oil
The Orient oil fields, we know that very well. In Imo State, everywhere is awash with oil, all the way from Ogun to Ohanji, the largest gas field in the whole of Africa. That is where Dangote wants to site his factory there. I want people to understand, all you idiots who out of stupidity, maybe lack of education and idiocy, think that it's all about oil. I'm just ruling it out for you. The largest gas reserve you have is in Ohanji, Ebema. For your information, Abia State has oil. I'm sure that some of you understand that very, very clearly. There is nowhere in our land Delta State has oil. River State, even Uroha, the same place, the same land, it has oil. Everywhere is oil and gas. Yet we cannot reason. Somebody will come and say, hey, you come here. You pig, come. Can you see this pipeline? Can you take care of it for me? He will say, oh, correct, sir. Rankadede, sir. Rankadede. Alhamdulillah, whatever rubbish the idiot says. And he will become a pipeline guard. And that's it. And his life is over. We are saying that such things are wrong. We are saying that we cannot continue that way. We are saying that we must address these issues head on. The only way to resolve it is freedom. Freedom for everybody. Fulani mediocrity cannot continue. Fulani idiocy can no longer suffice. Fulani backwardness can no longer obtain. People must do something about it, and that's exactly what we are doing. If you have common sense, you ought to join us. Zamfara, they bought machines, equipment worth $3 billion. Who gave Zamfara state government $3 billion? Who gave them this money? The money they are making from illegal mining. Nobody's arresting them. Nobody's shutting them down. The army is not going there, burning down villages. Of course not. Some of you fail to understand the game plan of these people. Because we are revealing their game plan, that is the reason why they want to shut down Radio Biafra. Because they know through what we are preaching, people are now beginning to acquire some measure of common sense. Why would Zamfara be processing their natural resource which is in the ground, and people from Biafra land cannot do the same with the oil and gas, coal that God gave to us? Oil, gas, coal, iron ore, we have everything. Why can't we do it? Why must the government take over? These are the questions that we are asking, and people are not and will not be able to answer it. Because Nigeria is a place full of hypocrisy. It's a place where people are filled with double speak. They say one thing in the morning, they say another thing in the afternoon, they say another thing in the evening. Nobody quite knows if they're coming or if they're going. Nobody understands the mess that they're in. Until they listen to Radio Biafra, until they listen to this very platform, they now come to the realization that they've been lied to all along. I want to let you understand all the news about SARS. How many things have you heard about SARS? The same SARS that I tweeted, they've been scrapping SARS for the past 4 years. Every month they scrap it. Every month they kill an innocent soul and they scrap it. And every month SARS grows from strength to strength, or should I say from infamy to infamy, from skullduggery to skullduggery, unbelievably so. Because you have a set of people who have this sense that Fulani can do anything and get away with it. Nobody can hold Fulani responsible. They are in the army, they are in the police, they control everything, they are in the government, in Asorok, they are everywhere. That is the reason why people fail to rise up to challenge them and to say that Fulani, what you're doing is very, very wrong. Now, why we can't scrap SARS? This was the same police that only 2 days ago, only yesterday, was telling you, we've scratched them, we don't want them on the road. All of a sudden, this very day, this very 7th, there is a news breaking why we cannot scrap SARS. Can you believe such nonsense? From the same police force, from the same police headquarters. They cannot scrap it because it is a Fulani agenda to reduce population of young men and women in the South. It is simple common sense. You have some people from the same South telling you that they want to become one Nigeria. We want to be one Nigeria. This is our great country. And I'm asking them, if you can name one episode in history when Nigeria was adjudged to be great from something that they have done, produced, accomplished, then all well and good. Just tell me when. None. Their history is empty. It is replete with failure, mediocrity, looting and stealing of public funds. That is all they have done. What else have they done? That is why one morning they're telling you, oh, we are scrapping SARS. The next morning, the same SARS is still there. Why we cannot scrap it? IG have written a press release signed by the IG of police.
Ahmed is his name. He signed it to please some of you, to make you think, or maybe should I say to assuage some of your feelings, to get you to stop rioting, to get you to stop coming out to demonstrate to you, or seeking for justice for those who were illegally murdered by these same SARS. They said it yesterday and 2 days ago. Oh, the SARS is going to be scrapped. Everybody will end SARS now. End SARS now. 7th of October 2020. Why we cannot scrap it? The same thing. And that was why I tweeted what I did almost 2 days ago. I said it. For 4 years, they've been banning SARS. But they've been going from strength to strength. I'll read this news for you. The first public relations officer of the Zoo Police Force, Zoo, is Nigeria. Mr. Frank Mbam, a deputy commissioner of police, has said that the special anti-robbery squad, SARS, a special arm of the force, cannot be scrapped because of the ongoing fight against crimes in the country. From force headquarters, the same office as the IG of police, the same. So that means IG did not consult Mba, or Mba did not consult IG, or maybe Asorok have phoned them, maybe Garba Shehu or the masked idiot, or maybe Aisha, saying, what nonsense are you talking about? SARS must be there. They need SARS to reduce the population of young people in the South, and they will pay a very heavy price for it. They know who we are. they are going to pay a very heavy price, I assure you. We are waiting for them to kill one more soul, and then they will see. They will see. I say it live on air that the whole world may hear. We can't, it's called self-defense. You can't allow these people to come from the north and keep slaughtering people. This keeps things. SARS now targets people in Biafra land based on their looks. They see a healthy young man, maybe who goes to the gym, who works out. They now start calculating how much they're going to get for his liver, how much they're going to get for his kidney. That's all they're calculating. They see the person, they kill the person, they open the stomach, and they harvest all the organs and they sell it. That's what they do. And you're telling me to believe in one Nigeria? Do you think we are foolish? You think we don't know what's happening in SARS in Okozo, in Anambra State? Of course, we know what is going on there. The same force that people were lamenting. That is one thing about black people. They never follow anything to its logical conclusion. They always stop halfway. They campaign, they tweet, they do, and they stop. They don't know that agitation is continuous. It is relentless. It is relentless. I remind people once again, two incidents that happened in the United Kingdom. One is the Hillsborough disaster. I am a Liverpool fan. The Hillsborough disaster. Sheffield Wednesday, Liverpool. That was in the year, that was in 1989 or 1990, it was. Hillsborough. Liverpool, the families of the victims kept campaigning. They campaigned and campaigned. Governments came and went. They campaigned and they kept campaigning. Again, it took nearly 28 years before the British government recognized that something went wrong at Hillsborough and agreed to have a public inquiry. They campaigned for 28 years. How about the massacre of the Irish? You know, what was it called again? The Easter Day Massacre. Easter Day Massacre it was, if you remember. They kept campaigning. People of Ulster, they kept campaigning for many decades until they got the result, until they got a public inquiry. Our people were shot dead at 10 minutes. People talked about public inquiry. Where are they today? Look at all the groups that talked about public inquiry. Look at all of them. Have they not gone silent? That is the thing about black people and white people. When white people campaign for something they believe in, they never stop until they get the desired result. That is the difference between white Europeans and poor, impoverished black Africans. And if you look at the lives of both sets of people, you will see a marked difference. Others are having fun. The other ones are in perpetual misery and pain. I'm asking you, how many of you have been able to sustain any campaign? For only 24 hours, you campaigned and you tweeted and you wrote and people said, oh, end SARS now, end SARS now, end SARS now. And the next day, after the IG of police must have said, we are ending SARS, they can no longer patrol, they cannot do this, the force public relations officer, another effluent, another idiot, Frank Mba, has come up to say you cannot stop SARS. SARS must continue killing. They must continue killing. Everything is a joke. Everything. I think they even brought in an entertainer. I think he's a musician. They started talking about him, talking with the police. Everything is a joke. In the zoo, everything is comedy. That is why the people that receive the highest amount of reactions and comments are comedians. Everything is a comedy. Everything is a bloody joke. Only that this time around is not a joke because people are dying. People are dying on a daily basis by these same people. All of a sudden, SARS is ending, and again, SARS is no longer ending. That is the zoo for you. That is all that you need to know about these people. There is no consistency. And the boy who was responsible for filming the dastardly deed of these people in Ureli, where they went and shot somebody, the person who videoed them or captured it on video was arrested. The same Festus Keyamo, who only days ago said nothing like that happened, is now asking police to release the person who shot the video. I have never seen such collection of idiotic people ever on the face of this planet Earth. That is why the Fulanis understand they can get away with murder, because they know that people are very, very foolish. They can do whatever they like. Fulani also understands, to be quite frank with you, if not for IPOB, Fulani Janja Wudism, the advancement of Miyeti Allah with their six terrorist groups would have overrun everybody by now, if not for the work that IPOB is doing through this very relentless broadcast on Radio Biafra. If you want us, as I was telling somebody to earlier today, I was very, very upset. I said maybe we should allow our people, we should allow Fulani to take over some parts of our land. Maybe it will wake them up. But then I realized that, having seen what happened in, in Uzuwani, what the Fulani Janjaweed did to our people, it never moved them. Unless they're still there, it never moved them. In fact, instead, if you go to Night Mile, you will see Fulani settlements in the bushes. You will see that if you're coming from Onitsha, if you take the express road, if you can brace that very road, you're coming from Onitsha, entering inside Enugu, you look on the right hand side, you can in Night Mile, you will see the settlements there, in the forest, in the bush, after killing us, after slaughtering our people. Somebody will see all of these things, and the worst part of it is that they will pretend they have not seen it. That is what is driving me mad. They hear, somebody heard about Uzuwani. Please, that idiotic hotel builder, few people should go and look for the headlines relating to what the Fulanis are doing in our land and tag him on the post so the idiot can see it. He said, no, Fulanis are not killing anybody. They have not done anything wrong, because they are the ones controlling him, they are his masters. Look at how they have predated our people because of the love of money. The love of money, they penetrate our people, they go into our hands, they go into our governors, they go into people who claim they are fighting for their people, and they bribe them, they mess up their brain. When they see evil, they cannot speak it anymore. Very sad indeed. Very, very sad indeed, and that is what we are here to counter. The police arrested the man who recorded where the SARS were brutally murdering people, killing people, slaughtering people in broad daylight. And they have done their campaign for only 2 days, and everyone has given up. Once the IG of police said, SARS will be confined, we don't want them on the road anymore, we don't want them on checkpoints, they slackened. That is the thing about black people. What is wrong with you people? Why can't you people stand on the side of justice and say that justice must be seen to be done? Why don't you insist until something happens? Why don't you insist until SARS collapses? Why don't you go after SARS until they stop what they are doing? You can't do it. You have written for 2 or 3 days, and after everything is over. Very, very sad indeed. Very, very sad indeed. And I feel sorry for you people. You animals in this zoological republic. That's why I call them animals, and some of them are not happy. That is why some of them take it upon themselves to be as idiotic as they have become. But one thing is certain. The truth that we preach is eternal. Nothing, and I repeat, absolutely nothing is going to stop it. The man who recorded the special anti-robbery squad, the SARS operatives, living and injured, he said living and injured citizen, they shot the guy in the head. They killed him. His name is Nicholas Makodomi. He was arrested. You know, really. He was arrested. And the people will just keep quiet. That is how, that is the level of fear that the Fulanis have put in you people, that you are scared. Nobody can speak the truth. If you want to speak, your mom or your dad will tell you, oh, don't say it, oh, don't say it, oh, you'll be arrested, oh, don't say it, oh. Everybody has now turned into a coward. If not for the work that IPOB is doing, if not for the work that Radio Biafra is doing, if not for the work that we have continued to do to defy every odd, by now, we would all have been cowards and Fulani would have been ruling Ebonyi State by now. But instead, they are putting their cattle in their Dangote trailer and taking them back to the north. That's what we said we are going to do, and we have done it. And some idiot will come and say, oh, but what are they doing? We want to see what IPOB is doing. Please show them that picture. That is what we did. No other person did it. We did. The idiots who are taking money from the zoo and talking rubbish every blessed day, they should go and see it. That is something that IPOB did. We promised and we delivered in Ebonyi that Fulani Janja Weed cannot take over Ebonyi State. Miyeti Ala cannot take Ebonyi State. It is impossible. We have now driven them from there. And they're going back. That is how strong we are. And with nothing. They have their 100 billion. We have nothing. Remember? Remember the 100 billion that was given to them by your so-called presidency? They have it, but we have nothing. Yet, we have won. And what is their Senate doing? You are in a so-called republic. You have people you claim are your senators and your lawmakers. What are they doing about the killings going on? Killings of ordinary citizens that did nothing wrong. Senate to probe extrajudicial killings. How many times have they probed something in the past? I want somebody to please remind the whole world of an incident where Nigerian Senate or House of Reps who probed anything and published their findings. Please go and show me. This is anytime they see people campaigning for something or agitating seriously for something, they tell you that, oh, the Senate will set up a judicial panel. They will set up a panel to probe, to look into that very matter, and nothing happens. Year in, year out. I am challenging all of them. Those of them in the Senate who are now claiming that they are going to probe the extrajudicial killings by SARS, which is against the law. Extrajudicial killings means they committed murder. They committed murder. Why are you going to probe them? All the probes you have done in the past of everything, of all these type of killings, of army brutality, police brutality, where are the results? Show me. Even their Senate, even their lawmakers, none of them is consistent. The ordinary citizens are hopeless, fearful, cowardly, and inconsistent. The same thing with the senators as well. How many times have they investigated anything before in the past and published it? I challenge anybody to please go online, go anywhere, go to any library and publish one single report of a public inquiry held by the Senate before. Now they have come. SARS are killing people. Instead of them to come out and say, SARS, you're killing people, a motion will be passed and you'll be shut down. No, they said they're going to investigate. Why? Because Fulani people in that very chamber is more than anybody else. That is why. That is the reason why. I know that some of them are very dumb. Some of them don't realize what they have done. But that is the fact of life. Very, very. It is very. There was something that I saw earlier today. Something that I saw about an emir, the appointment of an emir, Fulani emir, they said in Kaduna. El Rufai, the midget, made it very, very clear. Nasser El Rufai said, Fulani emir, which is to show you that no Hausa person can be a part of it. I don't know if I want it actually published on my page. That is what they do. They have frightened each and every one of you. They have shaken you to the bone marrow. That you are now fearful, you are now frightened. Even senators can no longer legislate to save the lives of the people. You are in a full-blown feudal, Fulani, backward, Janjaweed enclave. That is what is happening to all of you. This is the effect of Fulani Janjaweedism on every facet of life. That even senators cannot sit down to take a decision to save the lives of ordinary people, because the aim and the mission of the Fulani Janjaweed rulers in Asorok is to kill as many young people as possible in the south. I asked a question on Sunday. I said, can you show me an incident of SARS killing anybody in the north? Nobody can provide a proof. Whereas Asorok is a Fulani north. Senate is Fulani north. House of Reps, Fulani North, they are everywhere. Since they are not killing their own people in the North, they have no incentive to legislate to stop the killing by SARS of innocent young people in the South. Some of you need to open your brains. You cannot say it, but we can. And that is why we are preaching it the way we are doing this very day. They are going to probe, Senate to probe SARS. They have been probing. They have been probing for very many years, since 2015. Look at all the probes they have conducted. Look at all the inquiries they have told you that they have conducted. Has any of them resulted in anything positive? Did they even publish their findings? The answer is no. That tells you all you need to know. That tells you how terrible Nigeria is as a country. That tells you how horrible people who claim they are your leaders are. And that tells you finally that there is a grand plan by the Fulani to use every means possible. Miyeti Yala is in the forest killing you with their six terrorist groups. The SARS is there making sure that young people are eliminated. The army is there making sure that villages are sacked and burnt. All of you cannot see it. You cannot see what is happening. And I feel sorry for you. I feel sorry for you. That is why you are black. And when I say people get upset, I'm telling you, that is why you are a black person. The difference between a black person and a white person is because a white person, they use their brain. They can reason very well. And they act upon reason. Black people don't do that. What hope do you have? The people instructing SARS to go and kill are Fulani people who are in charge of your lives. Because until somebody gets killed in the north, you can never hear them come out and say, from today we have scrapped SARS. No. They cannot do it because they're doing a very good job for them. They are killing innocent people in the south. And all some of you from the south, I feel sorry for you. Those of you who rise against our agitation, those of you who come up to criticize or to try to say something very foolish about what we are doing. You want to attract patronage from the Fulani Janjaweed Asorok. You want them to notice you. You heard that they are sharing money. And because of that, you can say whatever rubbish that you like so that this money can come to you. Then you have failed. The Senate President Ahmed Lawan said banning federal SARS squad is not the solution. The Senate said no, they will not ban it. And that was why, imagine Senate is now overruling the IG of police who said it's going to ban them. All of a sudden, I told you, phone calls must have gone from one stupid office to the other. They have now called them. A whole Senate president who is, of course, from the north, is saying that banning SARS is not the solution to the extrajudicial killing. So what is going to stop it? Tell me anywhere in the world where a special police squad will be out to kill innocent young people from a section of that very country. Tell me where such rubbish has happened before. Only in the Zoological Republic. That is why I say to them that black people have no brain, they have no mind of their own, they cannot discern, they cannot reason, they cannot articulate their way out of any mess they find themselves in. Tell me why on this earth a whole Senate president will say that a murderous squad, Have they reduced crime in the country? The answer is no. Have they in any way done anything to dent the high levels of insecurity? The answer is no. All they specialize in is killing people, snatching mobile phones, stealing cars from people in broad daylight, claiming that they're the police. That's what they do. Instead of the Senate to rise up and make a law saying you cannot do this, they say no, you cannot ban them. Instead, fish out the bad elements and try them. How many times have you heard that there is a trial, a proper trial, you know, against any of these perpetrators of this heinous crime? The answer is no, you don't hear about them. You read about them in the newspapers and that's the end of it. Remember what happened in Abia, where an army officer shot dead somebody in broad daylight. They said, he's now going to be court-martialed. But instead, he was transferred to the north and he's still in the army receiving salary. That is what they do. People don't know they are in a cage. People don't know their lives have been messed up until it affects them. Until SARS kills your relative. Until that happens, you will not take what they are doing seriously. That is one thing about the brain of a black person that I find irritating. Must you wait for something to happen to you before you rise up and campaign for the society to do what is right? As I keep saying, that is the difference between white and black people. Very, very sad indeed. But as we are saying, we are there. It says, come and kill now. Come and kill in Biafra land. You will see what will happen to you. Come and kill. The highest thing you can do is you can abduct. You can detain. You can hand over to police. And we go to court. Let the court decide if the people that you are holding are guilty of the crimes that you're charging them with or not. Or else, any day SARS kills anybody anywhere, we'll set an example with the SARS of that very area that they may know how serious we are. If you're in doubt, you ask them in Enugu and they will tell you. If you're in doubt. Because we have done nothing wrong. The people you are killing, the people you are killing have done nothing wrong. You cannot see a young boy, a healthy boy. All you are thinking about is how much you're going to make from his liver, how much you're going to make from his kidney, how much you're going to make from his spleen, how much you're going to make from his pancreas. That's all they're thinking of. A policeman looking at somebody, all he's thinking of is money, money. How much can I make by selling his parts and his organs to Indian doctors? That's all he's thinking of. What sort of predatory society is that? I ask. What sort of society is that? Very, very sad indeed. These are the things that we're trying to highlight, that Facebook in their infinite wickedness and evil don't want the world to recognize. They said that their Senate will probe. How many times have we heard of that nonsense? And coming to the raging issue of restructuring and no restructuring, I want to place it on record that people can yap and talk all they like. We are not interested in Igbo presidency. We are not interested in a Biafran presidency. We are not interested in an Azon presidency. We are not interested in any restructuring of any kind. We are not interested in any restructuring. People can go and restructure their families. That is their business. What we want is freedom. Let the people decide in a referendum. The time has come for the people to decide, because power resides with the people and not with the idiots in Asorok or the Janjaweed Brigade intent on conquering and taking over everybody. Our people are being arrested as usual, and we have informed the world as always. Our media people are being arrested in Akwa Ibom State, and if you're holding them, I advise you peacefully to please let them go. They've done nothing wrong. Or you take them to court and let the court decide. You are wasting your time. You're not going to stop us. The more you arrest us, the more of us will come forward. The more you kill us, the more our mothers will give birth to. We are not going away until Biafra is restored. Anybody thinking that one day IPOB will cease to exist, or that one day we stop agitating or stop speaking forcefully as a group of people to demand to control their destiny, then you are mistaken. We are not going to stop. Not today, not tomorrow, not ever. That is why to us, I don't know how you see Biafra, I don't know how you see IPOB, but to us, Biafra is our religion. Here on radio, Biafra is where we worship, because Elohim Chukwukeka Biama Puruminjanina is our God. We are never, ever, ever going to stop until Biafra is restored. And as I told you, please keep your fingers crossed, very soon the world will talk about us. That I can assure you. With all the love in my heart from me, from here, it is good evening.